Yes, there will be casualties. But there will be new commissions. And those that are still shown that I can't finish amongst you. My heart, my body, sins. And you will do mighty works for me. But remember, I am still the king. And the bride is nearly ready. She is adorned with beauty. And I'm coming for her. But right now, hold tight. And you are going to see the mightiest time.
Your whole foot is caught. I decree and declare it to you. COVID stuff, I say that your foot is caught.
Yes.
And you're going to fall in your own trap.
Yes.
Amen?
Yes.
So Shannon called me and recommended to me this movie series called The Rain. Anybody know anything about it? The Rain. Okay. It's about the life of Mary, Queen of Scots. So she assured me, I asked her if the movie was clean. She said it was. And so I'm very interested in rulers and world history and how God moved on them, how God moved. So I'll get up on Netflix hoping to see a well-done historical movie. After a few episodes, I was horrified. At the poisoning, you know, Catherine poisoned everybody that got in her way. It was during the reign of Queen Catherine of France. And poisoned everybody. And chopped off heads and they didn't leave anything to be imagined in the movie. And murder of the royals in Europe to get them out of the way. And, you know, if a kid was next in line and wasn't one of them wanting to kill the kid, you know. Not to mention the debauchery of mistresses and horrendous things that went on in court, you know, which I don't doubt it. So I didn't hear them use God's name in vain, but the booty is not clean. I had to give it up. And the movie is set during the time of the Protestant uprising, Calvinism, which came against the Catholic Church in the 16th and 17th. A move of Christianity rose up in resistance to the Catholic Church and the rule that was over them. Kings were marrying and fighting to control nations. The queen of one nation, which was Queen Mary, is to marry the king of France so that they can, and she's heir to the English throne, so they can take over this whole thing. I don't plan on finishing the movie series. But Mary had a son, King James VI, who established what is now known as Great Britain through this lineage of all this. What I'm saying is God had a plan. And he transcribed the Holy Bible into English, now known as the King James Bible, and he was Protestant by the time he ruled. And you've heard me tell this story before, but many years ago, the Lord spoke to me, and I think this is when I was teaching, I was probably teaching at Ann's house before I started the church, that he had preserved the monarchy of England because King James translated the Bible into English. And this, did you just tell me that out of the blue? Why do I need to know this information? But I hold on to these messages I get that have to do with the nations. I believe Queen Elizabeth has been a godly queen as much as she knows. I believe she was saved under Brother Graham's ministry, Billy Graham. He ministered to her many times and ministered there many times. Ministered in the castle to her. I do not know how long the monarchy will continue through her children. However, it is God who has preserved the monarchy, set it up, and brought to my attention how he set these kings and queens together, and the evil ones got knocked off, and good ones got knocked off, but God was setting up a kingdom and has preserved it. And it will be preserved until God overthrows it. This is true of all the nations in the earth. I said, this is true of all the nations in the earth. God establishes nations and kings, and he brings down nations and kings. God said he was going to bring Kumo down because he would not repent. He's given him the last 8 months to repent. God brought Kumo down. Kumo. He will bring down other kings, he will bear JT, called him in. Praise God.
Hallelujah.
Ah, their character.
Hallelujah.
God will raise up kings and he will bring down kings. And why? Okay. So what this movie did for me, as much as I can bear it, was to show me black and in full color God's sovereignty of bringing together nations for his purposes long time. Do you think that same God has lost control of America? Do you think he lost control of the Middle East anywhere? Did he lose control of Israel? No. He has got this thing set in place regardless of how many poisonings and murders and overturning and that we have that goes on. Why is he doing that? He's setting forth a sovereign kingdom of his kingdom on earth, and he is going to bring together his chosen leaders for his purposes for the nations. Watching the movie was like watching a news channel in the 21st century as we watch the rise and fall of nations and leaders. There is no way that I believe that Ghani, who was the president or prime minister of Afghanistan, left with just a shirt on his back. No, he was part of the deal. Whatever deal Joe Biden cut to turn all that money, there's billions of dollars sitting there that they turned over to them, as well as all this equipment. Joe Biden cut a deal. And Ghani got his part. Because he left 2 weeks ago. They'll tell me he left with the shirt on his back. Didn't happen. The evil and wickedness in the 17th century is no different than the evil and wickedness in the nations today. I just got a full color picture of it when I was watching that movie. In Jeremiah 13:18, say to the king and queen mother, humble yourselves, sit down, for your ruler shall collapse the crown of your glory. Now, Catherine was the queen at the time Mary of Scots. Mary, Queen of Scots, was sent to France to marry her son. She was evil, mean. She was the one doing all the Polish poisoning and all the killing. 2 Samuel 22:28. You, Lord God, will save the humble people, but your eyes are on the haughty, that you may bring them down. The Lord our God, Jesus Christ, is moving down as he has always done since he created the world. He's moving as the sovereign over the nations of the earth. I said he's moving as the sovereign over the nations of the earth. He's also moving in each one of us, individually. We're being tested for our next kingdom assignment. And like the Israelites in the wilderness, the test is humility. We're being tested in humility. That's what they were tested in. And because they failed their test of humility, the Word of God says, and I'm going to read it to you in a minute because I'm getting ahead of myself, is that God put them in the wilderness for 40 years to humble them. And because they went down and humbled themselves to God when he told them to do something, and they refused to obey him and to listen to him, they were told they would die in the wilderness. So Christians, God is bringing forth at this time those who will humble themselves to God and obey him. In the obeying of God, we get the promised land. And if we do not, we are sent into the wilderness to die there. Moving on. Coming back to that. In Psalm 9, King David has explained experienced a great victory. He's giving thanks to God for his justice. This is the psalm of the conqueror, the overcomer, the victor, who is giving thanks for his victories. It is the psalm of triumph and reveals Jesus Christ in the midst of the church as he ever gives thanks to the Father. Jesus gave all glory to the Father. The singer rejoices in the exercise of Jehovah's sovereign rule in the whole earth. Psalm 9. The wicked are obviously the heathen nations, as well as the challengers to David's throne, both in his family and within his court and within his leaders. That same thing will happen in church. I mean, just get over it. There's going to be challengers who will challenge you. Because when they, if you get a crowd together, somebody wants to be over the crowd. Just so you know, I don't push over anybody. You can't say I ever did. Verses 1 through 4. I will praise you, O Lord, with my whole heart. I will tell of all your marvelous works. I will be glad and rejoice. I will sing praise to your name, O Most High. And when my enemies turn back, they will fall and perish at your presence. For you have maintained my right and my cause. You sat on the throne, judging in righteousness. You have rebuked the nations. You have destroyed the wicked. You have blotted out their name forever and ever. This is who our King is. This is who we serve. He has not changed his sovereign rule over the nations. Nothing has changed. And as long as we stay with him, whether we live or whether we die, we're with him. And this foolishness of this COVID fear that is putting on people, we have got to rebuke it, because the root of it is fear. They're trying to fear you, right, to make you afraid. Right in the middle of this big Afghanistan blow-up, Joe Biden gets up and tells you of another COVID epidemic. Tells you you're going to have to wear your mask. Threatens a lockdown, but he won't lock down the border. You talk about evil and corrupt. David's confidence is in who Yahweh is. Where's your confidence? I've been telling people that call me, they'll ask me, should I take the shot or should I not? They'll ask me that question. And I'll say, you've got to follow your peace. You've got to follow your faith. You have got to do what God tells you to do. And I fully expect, if God ever wants me to take the shot, I expect him to speak to me. My friend Sue Avery told me this week that she had checked what was in, I forget which shot it was, but it sugar and water and some DNA and a little bit of the virus. Sugar and salt. Sugar and salt. So, DNA and a little bit of the virus. We went another direction. I didn't go into the shop. Jesus is King forever, Judge of the world, Protector of the oppressed, Avenger of the blood, Protector of the needy, and rules in justice. Now, in the 17th century, in the 1st century, in the 18th century, and on up until the 21st century, until Jesus comes again. He will be continually dealing with the good and with the evil. Friday's prayer, the prayer net, was focused on the justice of God. Phyllis, let you know what the focus of the prayer could be. The Lord's justice is always accompanied by his judgment. You can go through by the Bible, put judgment and justice together, and you will, and they always go together. And this is what we're watching as these nations are being overturned. Johnny Inlow said in April 22nd, 2019, that there was going to be, God was going to have a great destruction. And if he did it all at once, it would be catastrophic. Well, I don't know about y'all, but I'm thinking we're getting into that catastrophic stage now. So I prayed this prayer on Friday, August the 20th. Rise up, O Lord, and let your enemies be scattered. And let them that hate you flee before you. O Lord Jesus Christ, I ask you to raise up a leader among the Afghan people who will execute the justice and judgment of the Lord. I pray your spirit will be upon leaders in Afghanistan as it was released from Moses to the 70 elders. I pray for your justice and judgment to be executed over the United States to Joe Biden and the administration which is called by his name. I charge the Joe Biden as an evil and corrupt leader who is under the spirit of destruction. Oh Lord, your anointed rulers are given divine empowerment to execute justice and judgment. Joe Biden is not empowered with the key of David, which is the ruler anointing, to execute justice and judgment. He does not carry the anointing of the king. The king is anointed by God to execute justice and judgment. He doesn't have it. I pray you restore to America your chosen president. Lord Jesus, you are that king. We're all the nations of the earth. And we come into agreement with your word that the shaking of all nations is your work. Your strange work as you overturn the evil and corruption in nations and you release your justice and judgment to the world. And we proclaim liberties to the captives in Afghanistan. Amen.
Amen.
Psalm 9, 6 through 8. O enemy, destructions are finished forever. O enemy, destructions are finished forever. You have destroyed, taken cities. Even their memory has perished. But the Lord shall endure forever. He has prepared his throne for judgment. I said, God has prepared his throne for judgment. And people say, well, Carolyn, you shouldn't go around preaching judgment. Well, I can't help it. That's what's going on in the earth. But at the same time, God's justice is being done for his people. He shall judge the world in righteousness. He shall administer judgment for the people in uprightness. The psalmist is saying here, thine is the kingdom, O Lord. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Verses 9 through 15 reveal the godly and the wicked one. The spirit of Antichrist, which has always been amongst us and is among us. We know that, and we can see it. JD, I was getting concerned about you, so I was praying you in. So glad you're here and you're doing okay, huh?
Yeah, I am, but I have another driver.
Verses 9 through 10. The Lord also will be a refuge for the oppressed, a refuge in times of trouble, and those who know your name will put their trust in you, for you, Lord, have not forsaken those who seek you. There is a strong Christian church in Afghanistan. That sheet posted this week that the Christian church in Afghanistan is the strongest Christian growth except for Iran. And that Iran is sending their missionaries into Afghanistan to establish churches. And these home churches, of course, are what is at risk. I am comforted to know that Iran, which is borders on Afghanistan, is perhaps able to get some of those Christians out over the border. But see, these Christians have to be strong Christians, or they wouldn't have come out of Islam. They wouldn't have had the courage to stand up for Jesus Christ. So they have to know God's word, and they are seeking Him. With COVID, the invasion of our southern border, and the fall of Afghanistan to Taliban, we are in a time of trouble. I don't see how anyone can paint this picture any different from their pulpit this day. Who are those who will put their trust in God? We have got to have a church that knows that God has a sovereign throne of justice over the whole world, and we have got to declare it from our pulpits that God is sovereign over the whole world, and He wants us to put our trust in Him, not what's going on.
Amen. Amen.
2 Chronicles 7:14. If my people, who are called by my name, will humble themselves and pray, and seek my face, and turn from their wicked ways, then I will hear from heaven and will forgive their sin and heal their land. What does it mean to humble ourselves? When I started this message, because see, I don't just wander, just don't say, whoops, here's the message. I wander into it. When I first started this, that was my first sentence until the Lord took me to Psalm 9. What does it mean to humble ourselves? Certainly not to lay down and let the other nations walk all over our back. That's Isaiah 51:22-23, where he says that they shall walk upon our back no more, and the cup that made us tremble we may put in the hands of our tormentors. I believe humbling ourselves means to repent from our carnality and sins and listen to God, obey Him, and be led by Him. I said be led by Him. That means all my preconceived ideas go out the door. But that means that any plans I have just disappear. Because I'm going to yield myself to God and be led by Him in these days, and Satan cannot touch me.
Amen.
If you're walking with God in the perfect will of God, Satan cannot touch you.
Amen.
Unless God allows it. And if He allows it, then He's dealing with you. Amen. So the story in Numbers 13:14 of when 10 of the 12 spies gave a bad report is a picture of the humility of Joshua and Caleb. You can say that Joshua and Caleb were brave, and they had faith. Yeah, but they had humility. That's what saved their neck. The people of Israel were afraid and complained to Moses that the giants were too big in the promised land. They just beat them up. All they heard was the evil report of the 10 spies. They did not see who God is and hear His promise to give them the victory and to deliver them. I'm here to tell you that there are spies out there right now giving you an evil report. I said spies. Who are these spies? They are spies of Satan. And they are giving you an evil report. The people carried on, crying. They cried all night. Bible says, wanting to return to Egypt so they'd be taken care of. Joshua and Caleb said, do not rebel against the Lord, nor fear the people of the land. Their protection has departed from them. Talking about the people of the land.
Yes.
The Lord is with us.
Yes.
Do not fear them. So I say that Joshua and Caleb were the humble ones because they believed God rather than the fear of the giants. God wanted to kill the whole church, the whole bunch of Israelites. He said, these people are not ever going to listen to me. They don't believe me when I talk to them. I tell them something, and they don't believe what I say. And they have seen all of my miracles that I brought them out of Egypt. I have fed them. And these people still don't believe me. I'm speaking to you, America. Moses interceded. I told Sandra this morning, God forgive me, I don't know if I would have interceded or not. Okay, but this rebellion cost the people 40 years in the wilderness. The spies were in there 40 days. The people got a year for every day they were in there. Okay, so that generation was not allowed to go into the promised land. 10 spies who brought the evil report about the land died by the plague before the Lord. 10 of them. Word God says, Numbers 14. They died by the plague before the Lord. Yeah. They brought an evil report. They did not bring the report of the Lord. Whose report will you believe? Because if we give the evil report, we leave ourselves open to the plagues and pestilence and whatever else is on the earth. I'm telling you. So you know. The people repented after he killed the 10 spies. They were so sorry. They had sinned. We sinned. We're going to repent now. We're going to get ourselves straight. They went up to the top of the mountain to go into Canaan to possess the land. It was too late. The Lord was not with them to give them the victory. And Moses told them, don't you go in and fight them. Because the Lord has lifted the blessing. The Lord's not with you. He says, the Lord will not be with you. That's the exact scripture. The Lord will not be with you. The blessing. They missed the blessing. They missed God. They would not humble themselves before God because they knew better. Y'all hearing me?
Yes.
Yes. The Amalekites and the Canaanites attacked them and drove them back as far as Hormah. The word of God says the Lord allowed them to wander in the wilderness for 40 years to humble. Deuteronomy 18. And you shall remember that the Lord your God led you all the way these 40 years in the wilderness to humble you and test you to know what was in your heart, whether you would keep his commandments or not. Deuteronomy 8:16. Who fed you in the wilderness with manna, which your fathers did not know, that he might humble you, that he might test you to do your good in him. Now, all of us have been in the wilderness. The Israelites were there 40 years, but God told them they would die, that generation would die in the wilderness, and they did. Paul was there 4 years. And Jesus was there 40 days. Now we're all going to go in the wilderness. But what will get you out is if you humble yourself before God and lay I believe the Lord gave this to me. See, I started out, and I have lots of scriptures I could use on humility. You know, I started out humble, you know. The Lord showed me that humble is Joshua and Caleb. Because they humbled themselves to God to obey Him regardless of the circumstances. That's the kind of humility that God is looking for in His church right now. God says, I'm going to get you through this. I've already planned it.
Amen.
All of this overturning, all of this that's going on in the nations. The Lord says, I have not lost control of it, but I will bring you through it, my dear people.
Yes.
I love you. I will bring you through it, but you must be led by me during this time in your personal life and in every area of your life. You must be led by me, and you will not perish in the wilderness. Wilderness will get rid of our issues.
Yes.
You're going to leave your issues in the wilderness.
Amen.
And don't get up in the pulpit and preach your issues.
Amen.
Lord Jesus. Our humility is obedience to the Lord rather than seek our own way, regardless of the circumstances or how right we are or think we are. Now, letting humility, Joshua and Caleb said the giants are not too big for us. We can go in and take them out. They weren't running and hiding in some cave to be humble. No. Their humility was that God said, we have the victory.
Amen.
So we can go in under the mighty hand of God, and He will give us the victory.
That's right.
That is the boldness of the Lord.
Yes. Amen.
But you got to know.
Yes.
You're being led by the Lord.
That's right.
That is humility.
Amen.
Praise to the Lord who dwells in Zion. Declare His deeds among the people. Zion is where the presence of the Lord is. Just, we're not going to fit all over there on that mountain. I've been there. When He avenges blood, He remembers them. He does not forget the cry of the humble. Have mercy on me, O Lord. Consider my trouble from those who hate me. You who lift me up from the gates of death, that I may tell of all your praises in the gates of the daughter of Zion. This is going to get you through the gates of death. Satan has gates of death right now, but he has a sign to the people in the United States. And I'm not saying that dear Christian brothers and sisters who have lost their loved ones through COVID are not humble. I am not saying that. Don't say it either.
Amen.
I'm just telling you what's going to get us through the gates of death in these days that are ahead.
Yes.
Because the gates of death have been released and Jesus overcome death, hell, and the grave.
Amen.
And what God has for you. If it's your time to go, then praise God, go. But let me tell you, God's going to get us. Humbling ourselves will get us through the very gates of death.
Amen.
And God doesn't care how right you are. He just wants you to do what He tells you to do.
That's right.
It's that simple.
Amen.
I told y'all. God, I've been to a really hard battle. Family battle. And I was right. I was very, very, very right.
Mm-hmm.
And the Lord spoke to me. He said, I want you to build me an altar.
Amen.
And I want you to put out all your rights and righteousness. And let it burn up.
Yes.
Save my family.
Amen.
I said it saved my family.
Amen. Amen.
I'm going to let you get your own battle. I'm going to watch.
Yep.
And if you come to me, I'll say, y'all better not be fighting. I'm not going to get in a fight with you.
Amen.
You know what? What would I fight with you about?
Right.
Because I've already laid down my rights and righteous indignation. All I do is preach the word of God and love you. You're on your own with the other stuff.
Hello.
Amen.
Amen.
You know, if you get in the mud hole with somebody, you're going to get mud on you.
Mm-hmm.
You just remember that when you need to go fix things.
Good word, Dad.
You've been trying to fix something, Judge Tate.
No, I have not. But
good for you.
I'm the wise man.
Yeah. Amen. Amen, JJ. I didn't read 11 through 15, did I? Huh? Sing praise to the Lord who dwells in Zion. I started preaching. Declare his deeds among the people. And when he avenges blood, he remembers. Does not forget the cry of the humble. Have mercy on me, O Lord. Consider my trouble from those who hate me. You who lift me up from the gates of death. That's what got me to preaching. That I may tell all of you your praises in the gates of the daughter of Zion. I will rejoice in your salvation. The nations have sunk down in the pit which they in the net which they hid. Their own foot is caught. And in Psalm 9, the psalmist declares that God is sovereign over justice. And even me watching that movie, some series of little movies or whatever, God was showing me how he was at work then. Sovereign of those who are sitting on rulers and thrones. He was bringing it to my attention that he never lost control of what was going on in all that wickedness to bring about his end. You and I are still reading King James Bible. If nothing else came out of it, today you and I are reading the King James Bible. And we may read 90 other interpretations. But if you're like me, I'm going to go back to the King James Bible and compare how it's read.
Yes.
Amen.
I'm not vindicating anyone. I'm just telling you. Okay. This is what happened to the Biden administration in Afghanistan. The nation of the United States has sunk into a deep pit that was made by the Biden administration. And they've done all this under hiding. And the net which they hid, their own foot is caught. I decree that over the Biden administration. Known by the judgment he executes. The wicked is snared in the work of his own hands. The wicked shall be turned into gold. Now, do I believe that everyone that died in the wilderness wasn't saved? No, I don't believe that. But they repented along the way and God cleaned them up. But their punishment was they never got out of the wilderness all of their life. And at, when we come through the wilderness, we enter the rest of God. Hebrews. And all the nations that forgot God, the needy shall not always be forgotten. The expectation of the poor shall not perish forever. Arise, O Lord, do not let man prevail. I said, arise, O Lord, do not let man prevail. Arise, O Lord, do not let the Joe Biden administration prevail because it is evil. Arise, O Lord, do not let the rulers of nations who are part of this debacle prevail, for they are evil. Do not let man prevail, O God, but rule for us from the sovereignty of your throne of justice. Let the nations be judged in your sight. Put them in fear, O Lord. The nations may know themselves to be her end. Psalmist cries like ours today. I know you've been grieving. I know your hearts are broken over what you're seeing all over, but mine is. We are asking God through his word today, I'm decreeing it. I'm not preaching, I'm decreeing it. To take drastic action on behalf of the weak and underprivileged and to bring justice against the wicked. I wrote down because I was began singing it.
Thank you.
God is calling you to repent. And you might say, you're already home on the note. But I believe there's a choosing going on right now all over the United States. For those who will humble themselves in the sight of the Lord, they're going to walk forward into a, being led into the Spirit, into a glorious glory of the Lord that we have not seen. And those who hold on to their I know better, I know all about it, and I know among the men that spend their lives, they will die for going to miss God's best. So ask God to check your heart, even though you might be perfect. Ask Him to check your heart as this song plays. Have we got it? Huh? Okay, we're going to sing it. Okay. I'm going to ask you to watching that, what's going on, just stay before the Lord.
Going to be many people that are going to be in awe of their humility because they chose Jesus.
Yes.
And they chose to face death. That's humility.
Go ahead and bring it. Got it? That all volume of God. as I have charged Joe Biden today. Lord, I also pray for him to humble himself before you and do that which is right in your hearts, and that he will stand up and abandon the plan of his advisors. And but Lord, I pray that he will humble himself before you.
Amen.
To save our nation and the nation of our friends. And Lord, we know that if he will not do it, you will raise up another in his stead.
Yes, Jesus.
And that another will do your bidding and will do that which you have told him to do. And that you will have a ruler in the land who will do that which you have called them to do for your purpose, for the destiny of nations. Oh Lord, I pray for Joe Biden today to humble himself before you. And if he will not, let another take his place.
Amen.
Yes. Yes, Lord.
Wow.
That would be kind of embarrassing.
Amen, but we don't have to be. It can be. Doesn't have to be common. What God has anointed and chosen, not what men. Not what men are doing and men are saying. That was the scripture, and I just read it.
Amen.
Not being led by men, but the sovereignty of God's justice from His cross. Let's take communion. Before we do, let's ask God to forgive us. We have aught against any brother or sister. We forgive them. Okay, do you know that forgiveness is humility? Forgiving someone whether they deserve it or not. Did you deserve God's forgiveness?
No.
So if you forgive someone, that doesn't mean they deserve your forgiveness. That means you're more humble than they are. The Lord is one. God's doing this dealing. So anyone, Lord, that we have not forgiven, Lord, I ask you to put forgiveness in our heart.
Yes, sir.
And Lord, that we will truly forgive that person.
True.
Our sons, however many they are. And we won't hold anything against them. Before we take this communion, in Jesus' name we pray.
Amen.
Okay. I get wonderful joy to have this little table. It's just very useful to me. This body